Hi everybody, welcome to Janet's Crochet Journey. Today is Wednesday, September 28th, 2022. Welcome to all my new returning and future yarny friends. Okay, take two. I had an interruption and I don't do editing and all that fandangle stuff because I don't know how. So I'm starting over. Okay, last video, it was said by someone that you had a hard time hearing me. I upload on my phone, or I record with a microphone, upload it to my YouTube, and then I go on my laptop and I listen through it to make sure there's no problems, because I had a problem before and it sounded okay to me. But if for some reason there continues to be an issue with my sound, please let me know and I will either try recording from a different device or buy a new microphone. I don't like to clip it to me because all the rustling and the static and what have you can be annoying to some people as well. So I'm just trying to do what I do without all the techie stuff, because that's just not me. I mean, I'm not dumb, but when you get into the more detailed of the stuff, I don't have the time. Okay. So, as you can see from the title, whatever I title it, in the process of going through and rearranging my yarn craft room, I came across a lot of yarn that I got in mystery bags, mystery boxes, some surprise exchanges, some things I bought because I wanted to try and I just can't use them. So I do have giveaways, but I don't want people to end up with some things that they don't want. So I don't want Etsy at this time because I've heard good and bad about that, and so I'm going to try it this way first. If anyone has any suggestions, you know, I'm more than willing to hear you out, either in the comments or my email at johnnamiller73@yahoo.com. And I'm going to show the yarns that I am willing to sell to people, and my minimum is like the shipping. You know, I'm not out looking to, you know, double or triple my money. I know I've shipped around the eastern, upper to lower south states on giveaways, and the shipping was anywhere from $12 to $15 in the pink bags that I send. So, you know, if you're interested in something, just email me, and you know, if we could figure out the shipping, I am in Western New York. You know, and you throw in a few extra bucks just to make it worth the trip to the post office. Like, that's all I'm looking for. I'm not, you know, looking for retail or, you know, it's just everybody knows the shipping, you know. I would like to stay in the U.S. only, but if someone in Canada, you know, knows what it costs and says, hey, I really want this, I'm willing to pay this, just email me. You know, I'm a very flexible person. You know, I just go with the flow. I don't want any drama. Or if you know a better way, should I do mystery bags? You know, any input for anybody who's done this before. Okay. I think that's everything. If I think of something else along the way, it might be two videos. Did I say that this time? I don't know. Because I don't want to take up too much of your time. So I'll start with what I have in front of me. I bought yarn to try to make socks. And I can't do it. I love this yarn. I love the colors. As you can see, I tried. I failed. I frogged it. But this is two skeins of Premier Yarns Wool Free Sock. It's a new print called Cool Water. It's a fine two, and I can't use it. So, la la la, how many yardages? Just keep twirling it. 235 yards in each, and I have two. Cool Water. Wool Free Sock. Okay, so there's two in that, and I'll rebag it after. I have two, another new print. The label says, now I don't know, because I was just trying. Love this color as well. This is a super fine one called Timeless. Love the colors. Wish I could with my arthritis. I just cannot work with this thin yarn. Two of those. And 235 yards each. Then in a mystery box, I received a two fine 210 yards per skein colorway turquoise reef yarn bee cozy toes. I have two of those. When you email me, if you're interested in just one color, all the sock yarn, you know, whatever, just let me know. So then I also have three received in a mystery bag. Says it's machine washable, 193 yards a piece, color 23, filatura, whatever, fashion toes, 90% superwash merino wool and 10% nylon. And again, I have three of these. Pretty colors. I would love to make socks. I just can't do it. I can't. Okay. So then I have four oddballs I got in a mystery bag from somewhere, made in Mexico. So this says 100% algodon, which I'm going to assume is cotton. I could have looked it up, but I didn't. Sorry. 415 yards and, you know, this is the color. It's browns, light tans, I don't know, a cream. So this is the label. One of those. I have one another one that was made in Mexico. Not sure what color it is. It's almost like a yellowy something. Same thing, but in like a light peachy color. These are all made in Mexico. I'm sure if you know what you're looking at, you'll know the name. And then this one, mimosa, 62% algodon, which I'm again assuming is cotton, 38% rayon, 240.5 yards, some type of a grayish with kind of specks on it. Okay, so then I one Red Heart Scrubby, 78 yards in the color Candy. I have a Yarn Bee Scrubology in black. And then I have 18 folks. And actually, I have 18, 26 total because I have doubles of some. Now, this is a medium four, 100% cotton with fringe, Mary Maxim scrub it with that little fringe on the end. And this is hot blue, 76 yards, 100% cotton. So I have hot blue. This is called Splash. These also have 76 yards. Some of them I have doubles, some I don't. There's an orange, pink. With the very different colors. Some of these would go together. You could pair them with regular cotton. There's a purple. This is a cornflower blue with tan. That would be more like with this one. I hope these colors are coming out for you. If you wanted separate pictures sent to your email, just give me a shout. I'm okay. If you want all of these, some of the colors, I have tried working with this in, putting two yarns together. It's not something I go to. I have way too many projects on my list to do that. Okay, trying to stay with cotton-ish blends that I know right off the bat. I also have washi in red and orange, three in a pack, never opened. It's pretty rough. Can do it. So then I'm keeping a couple bags of this, but this is an extra one of it. Looks like cotton. I'm not sure if you can dye it, but there's three. And it was a 1 pound mill end. So I have one of those. And these four, two of each, also look like they can be dyed. I don't dye yarn. I have two of this Lamia natural wood from South America. Says it's a four, 218 yards. It's two of those. And these have no labels, but these were in mystery bags from Bag O' Day. I just don't dye yarn. Okay, then I have Yarn Art Tahiti, 50% bamboo, 50% cotton. It's the color 216. It's a 2 fine, 2 4. There's 8. Comes in a zipper bag. Is that upside down? And again, you know, you can pick and choose, stop the video, write stuff down, send me an email, johnnamiller73@yahoo.com. And we can figure out a price, if we can figure out shipping, or if people in the comments say just do mystery bags at so much a piece that would include shipping. Anyone who's done this before, I would appreciate it. Okay, some other things I have that I'm not going to use. I know when I make gnomes for Christmas, I could use this, but mystery bag online, the yarns I got, no. So there was 3 of this Fun Fur prints. You know, and this is like a trim on something. I got 3 of this color called Sandstone. I'm not going to use this. It would be cute. It's a great idea, but no. And this other one is called Festival Mixed Fiber Polyester Acrylic, 50 grams. That's all it says. Again, could be used for trim, but I know me, I don't have time to fiddly around with that. Okay. All right. I have a Mary Maxim Baby Splash Sport Weight, shade 13. $164. It's just in a color red. If someone orders something, I could just throw it in. It could pass for a 3, but I don't know. Then I have a 4-pack of Diana. It says it was $279 a skein. 285 meters, 100 grams, 80% acrylic, 20% wool. It's like a gray, white, marly. I don't know if that helps. No, yes. Upside down again. There we go. 4-pack of this. And this stuff is beautiful. I was thinking about saving it for if I do a Christmas exchange. I may still, if no one wants to purchase it. There's no labels on these two, but they both sparkle. So I'm going to show you one at a time. All it says is a product code. There's 5 skeins in it. Could have been in a mystery. Okay, it looks very thin. And I'm not sure if you can see it, but there is sparkle. So there's a cream. And this is a brown. Let me see. Hole in the bag. Can you see that? That's sparkle. And there are 2, 4, 6 in this brown color with like a brown tinsel going through it. And I'm watching my clock because if I need to, I'm gonna make this 2 short videos for sure. just so people don't get overwhelmed. And then when you email me, you could say in video one and like kind of narrow it down a little bit for you. And then also in the one mystery bag with this fun fur, I got three. This is like a bulky five. And it's like a, it's pretty, but I feel like there's wool in it because it's not, I don't know. I just feel like I could itch, but I mean, it's not, I mean, it's a soft wool. Like some of you may have gotten this before. Maybe the person got it in a mystery bag and we're selling mystery bags. I think it was on Ravelry or Etsy that I got this bag. So I can't tell you how much, but there's three of these. And again, it feels like a bulky five. And this, it's called Fashion Plus, a mill end. I have not opened the bag. I'm afraid it's going to be like this. But there's four of these. And, you know, if you want me to open it and send you a better picture, it's like a gray, mauve orange. So there's four in the mill-end bag. And so, yeah, I think the last one for this video will be these three. I got reduced down to 72 cents a piece. Artiste, mercerized Egyptian cotton, 400 yards, number 10 crochet thread. Okay, so these have 400 yards, probably because they're solids. Crochet thread number 10. This is crochet thread number 10, but 300 yards. I love that color. I thought, you know, doing doilies would be pretty, but I can't. So there's that. All right, I'm going to click off here and I'm going to get video number 2 done, which I will probably post that tomorrow. And then I'll put my email in the description box if you're interested. If you, again, have comments about how it would be a better way to do this. You know, if you feel like, hey, just make up mystery bags and, you know, 20, 25 bucks a piece to cover shipping in the U.S., wherever, you know, anybody that's done it, I would appreciate it. All right, guys, enjoy your Wednesday and, like, subscribe and share, and we'll see you next time. Bye.